Hi, it's Tracy from Two Rocks Tarot, and today I'm going to be sharing a little bit of a different deck. It's the Playing Card Oracles, but by Anna Cortez, and the illustrations are by her father, who unfortunately passed away back in 2010. But I'm going to be talking about the book first, and I first heard about this book on Natalia's channel. I think it's Oboris, I always pronounce that wrong, and she was saying how great this book was, and I thought this really, really sounds interesting. So I went over onto Anna's website, and she actually had this available for a free download through PDF. So I printed it out. So this is what the cover of the book looks like. So I thought I would just talk a little bit about the book. Now, of course, it's going to be shiny. You're not going to be able to read it. So I'm just going to read what's in it, just a few of the highlights I felt. I'm still actually reading the book. This is quite a lot of details. So this is actually a playing card oracle deck, and this is the box. As you can see, it's just your standard little tuck box. But what piqued my interest in this is how my grandmother used to read. Now, I never knew that she read the cards until she passed away many years later. It was only when I actually took up the tarot myself that my mother told me that she used to read normal playing cards. And I've always been interested in it, but I could never find a book that actually explained it very well. I did buy one book, but it's really, really crap, you know. You know, it's got this woman who's dressed up as a gypsy, all the cliche things, and it was just crap. But this book is absolutely freaking fantastic. It explains everything. So she's got here, I wanted to about the calendar correspondence. So of course it's got 52 cards in it, which equals the 52 weeks in a year. There's four suits, which are the four seasons in a year, and there's 13 cards in each suit, which 13 weeks in each season, 13 lunar cycles in a year. So total of numbers in each suit, counting the aces as 1 and the jacks as 11, queens as 12 and kings as 13, equals 91, and there's 91 days in each season. So total of numbers in the decks is 364, which of course is 364 days in a fixed lunar year. So of course she goes on to talk about the colours and everything like that, but I've just actually thought I would just go to what I have been reading, what I have found interesting. And this is another little tidbit I thought was really, really good. Among the court personalities featured in this card reading system, you will find the lady cards, long ago discarded from the court and labelled as simply a 10. This upset the balance of male and female within the court and put a two-digit number in the faceless grouping of single-digit cards. The picture book of Anna Cortez is, among other things, an attempt to rectify that situation. So I thought that was quite fascinating, actually, that they were just discarded. Of course, it goes on about all the you know, what the numbers mean and everything like that. Try not to wobble this table too much. And then it goes on explaining each actual suit. So here, the diamond suit, the magical name is Ignita. The element is fire, direction south, season autumn, phase of life, midlife. Principal body part is the head. Compatible suit is the clubs, and the key concept of the diamonds is prosperity, creativity, self-confidence, transformation, and spiritual growth. And it goes in, as you can see, it goes into quite a big spiel about it, and it does that with all of them. So the clubs is magical name is Ethra, element is air, direction east, season summer, phase of life adolescence, principal body part throat, compatible suit diamonds, key concepts, ideas, thinking, dreams, communication, detachment, and that's, you know, that sort of thing. So I'm not going to go through all of them because otherwise it'll be a huge video. And then as you can see in this book, it's got a picture of the actual card, so a complete picture. So this is the ace. So I'm just going to read this, but that's not too much. Oh, I might just read here. So it's got potentials for financial gain or creative endeavors, a strong sense of self and a person's own individuality, the ego, the will to do, to achieve, spiritual values and transformations, an engagement ring, a diamond. So, and then it'll go into what this actual, a bit more detail of what this actual card means and what to look for in the card itself. Because in here, in the large red diamond, red diamond, in the center looks like more like a gem than a traditional suit sign. And if you look at it closely, you'll see a figure silhouetted within its core. So this is supposed to be the story that follows illuminates the symbolisms of this ace, and it goes into a story there. I'm not going to go into all of it, but this book, just, you know, and it's every single card, you know, you've got a picture in it. Where am I up to? So as you can see, it's quite, I think it was 250 pages or something like that. And then it's got the, which I really love, love, love this. This is about generating suit energies. So here it's got diamonds. So this is your internal fire. Spend some time getting in touch with this element. Watch the sunrise or sunset. Sit in the presence of burning candles. Build a roaring campfire, make an offering to it. Vigorous exercise generates internal friction and turns on your body's furnace. Give yourself an aerobic workout. Biking or a vigorous heart-pounding walk works wonders. Seek inspiration through inspired writings or talks. Boost your financial confidence by keeping a $100 bill tucked into your wallet. I wish I could. It'll make you feel wealthy every time you see it. But I love the way that she actually talks about working with the energy, with each element. So the actual elemental energies of the deck. It's absolutely fabulous. And of course, it's something that you can incorporate and should incorporate in, you know, into your tarot readings. But sometimes you can sort of forget about that in the midst of it. She also, I haven't read, I'm up to this bit, is Divinatory Geomancy. So she goes right into that, quite a lot into that. So I look forward to reading that. And there's another thing that, oh no, I haven't come up to that yet. It's, she goes into the approximate dates of the season. So for winter, December the 22nd to March the 20th. So that's summer for us here, excuse me, in Australia, you know, spring, summer and autumn. So she goes into that. And I think I've missed one. There was something that I thought was really, really good. Oh, maybe I've missed it. I'll go back. Of course, she does go into the spreads as well. So there's quite a, you know, there's some good spreads in here. So here we have the backs of the cards. And as I said before, it just comes in your, you know, your normal everyday little tuck box. I have read on the reviews in Amazon that people were complaining about the size of the cards. They're 2.5 by 3.5 inches, and I don't find that too small at all. I think the trouble is when you have a smaller card is that sometimes you do not see the detail in it, which is not like that with this deck whatsoever. The detail in this deck is absolutely amazing. It truly, truly is. So let's have a look at the cards. And these are actually in order. So here we have got the Ace, and that's the one that I was reading about in the book. And if you have a look in there, there is an actual little figure. So as you can see, the size of the cards really don't matter, do they? That, to me, it's just perfect for shuffling. They shuffle absolutely beautiful. The card stock is really, really good. It's nice and, you know, nice and shuffle, nice and easy to shuffle with. Here we have got the Two of Diamonds. I mean, have a look at the images. This is what drew me into this deck. As much as I wanted to learn the way my grandmother read the cards, just seeing two diamonds on a plain white background did nothing for me. But this really ignites your intuition, your imagination. It's absolutely freaking fantastic. I love the images in this deck. I think they're superb, and I'm really looking forward to working with this deck. This is the Necklace. Actually, what I might do so that I don't slip and slide everywhere, I'll do it this way. She actually has four cards to represent the compass. So this is the South Wind. I mean, have a look at the picture. Look at the face on it. It's absolutely fantastic. And so, of course, it will go in, you know, about what the South Wind represents, you know, in the reading. I really highly recommend to get the bigger book. It's much, much better. This is the Peddler's Ace. Five of Diamonds. So I think this is going to be really easy, a really easy deck to learn with and to connect with, because it's, you know, because I'm a pictorial reader and I really need pictures on a deck, you know. I mean, I could read pip decks, I can see things in the pip, but this is absolutely fantastic. I really love it. Got the sword on the back with truth, conviction, courage, you know. It's got prudence, trust, Perfection and what's that one? Illumination. So, you know, it's beautiful. And I love the colours too. I really like the yellow. I don't know if I could edge this deck, if I could find a yellow, like an ink like that, I think I would edge it in that. House of Good Fortune is there. Here we come to Gawain. Tendra. The pictures kind of remind me of, particularly the male in this figure. My grandparents are German. It reminds me of the German illustrations that she used to read to me in books. But isn't it just absolutely beautiful? Livia. So this is one of the females that I was talking about. That's been put back. She's got the astrological associations as well to this deck. So now we come to the spades. This is the Ace of Spades. I'm really looking forward to learning with it. And this, I think this is the image that made me, when I saw that, I thought, oh, I've got to have this deck. I just love that image, the Two of Spades. Really, really good. It's almost like he's arguing with himself because this particular one's got horns and the other one hasn't. Here's the North Wind coming up. Just facial expressions are absolutely fabulous. They really are. Beautiful. It's just beautiful. I could look at these forever. As soon as I saw these images, this deck was really, really cheap. It cost me, even including postage, $23.95 to get to Australia. Now, she did have a, which is already sold out, she did have a limited edition for $79, but being US and to get the postage, it was just way too much. And I actually saw this one on Amazon and I thought, I'm going to grab it. It's absolutely perfect. I love this one too, Throne of Spiders. It's just brilliant. I just love. So they've got other decks as well. I mean, you can have a look on her website. I will put a link down below. So if you're interested in the book, you can download it and have a read of it. But I think it's going to be a really highly intuitive deck to read with. I think it's going to be great. And I like this one too. I like all of the cards. I can't deny it. I think they're all beautiful. Okay, Morgana here. I hope that shadow is not too much on there. No, I might be able to tweak it a little bit. Marduk the Heartless. It's just such a fantastic deck. It truly is. Now we come up to the hearts. I love this one. Ace of Hearts. And the descriptions that she, you know, the meanings for this that she gives in this book are absolutely brilliant as well. You'll pick this. I think you'll pick this up very, very easily. And this is what I was looking for. I did buy the illuminated playing card deck, which I did love, which comes with two. But this one tops it. This one is great. I mean, have a look at this, the Three of Hearts. I love it. You could easily have that as the Three of Swords. You know, there's lots and lots of things that can be read in that particular image of this card. Here we come to the West Wind. Isn't it just beautiful? And if you actually look, she's actually a hag, so it's just an illusion. It touches on all of the artwork. So all of the meanings that you get in that book, it touches on the art. It relates to the artwork, which is what I love. Nothing worse than buying a deck such as this has got fabulous images on it, and they just give you a standard meaning. It's not so in this deck. Everything relates to the artwork in it, which is absolutely fabulous. It really, really is. Isn't it beautiful? And I love the way there's you know, it's the color theme, it all matches so nice. And then we've got these black ones in there. I think that's awesome. Now, this particular gentleman was very, very an evil guy. If anybody wants to, I don't even know, I won't try to pronounce it. I think it's Giles de Rais. But yeah, just Google him to find out why. Come to Allegra. That's really beautiful. Just the facial expressions are wonderful. They really, really are absolutely wonderful. I love this one too. You're coming to the clubs now. This is a final suit. I love this card as well. If I remember rightly, that one talks about trusting your intuition. Here is the East Wind. So with this particular deck, it's very, very easy to predict when things are going to happen. She's got a great calendar spread in there on reading with them. It's got a few spreads in there which are really, really good, and I look forward to trying them for myself. The pictures are, I don't know, I just, there's just something awesome about them. Sword of Enchantment. So these are all illustrations that her father painted. So he's got his little signature on all of them. So I think it's CJF99. Galahad. Lancelot on that one. Lee, my middle name, but not spelt like that. And then the final card is this one. So there you have it. That is the Playing Cards Oracle and Divination deck by Ana Cortez and CJ Freeman, her father. So yeah, $23.95 including postage to get to Australia, which is unheard of. And I wasn't actually supposed to get this till October, and I actually got it a week early. It's really, really weird. When I buy things from the Book Depository, which I haven't done for a long, long time, sometimes it can take nearly 2 months to get to me. This did get posted from America, or so it said, but I got it, you know, within a couple of weeks, which is amazing. So it's I highly recommend this deck. I'm really looking forward to working with it. The book that comes with it is absolutely fantastic. She's got a few other books out there. She does have a YouTube channel as well, so I'll be watching that, some of the explanations on working with the cards as well. I hope you've enjoyed this, and until next time, this is Tracy.